Disgust. Smelly water. Stinks of rotten eggs. I'm running from the smell through the forest so fast. The trees looked like they were running as well. The birds chirping wistfully and an orchestra playing for a soundtrack. Pizza from 2 minutes ago, soft and juicy in my mouth. I'm so scared I will get eaten by a group of ogres and take me back to the den. I am so terrified that the ogres will jump out of trees.
Character doesn't really have a name. She was born when the Earth was created, and she's on a quest to break this curse that she was born with. The curse is that she can't have friends, and she can only live by herself in the cave, and she can only be on herself. She has a good personality. She has a knife in her pocket for protection. It's made out of bronze. She's scared of people and light, because she doesn't know what they're light like. She's been there forever. And she's tired of not knowing what the world is like. She sings every night to the gods, the cave, and people outside wonder what she is and who she is and would like to make friends with her. She wants to be free from this curse. She can't because there's no way to break it really, right? If she has friends, she will die. That's it.
Deep. Ancient, damp, a malignant mold, the kind that creeps and seeps into your soul. A constant tapping, as if there are actually such creatures as knockers. Tap, tap, tap. Stale, damp air and a sour copper, the foul taste of my blood. Freedom. I once had it, and how I wish to taste it once again. I'm empty. My entire being is devoted to my escape. My stomach is twisting in knots. My eyes can only distinguish vague, melancholy blues, greys, and long strips of white. Creatures stand around every corner I turn, twisting off of the walls. Every stalagmite, a hand, every stalactite, a long arm reaching. I want freedom, pure, blissful freedom. Freedom that can never be realized as long as I am stuck here.
I hear birds tweeting and the sound of rivers crashing. I taste the mud that is in my face. I think I'm going to get caught again. I feel very cold and depressed. I see nothing because I am stressed. I imagine my family being right here beside me. I dream that none of this is real.
A wet, damp Siberian husky and water splashing against the rocks. Smoke, stale coffee, gone off bread and rotten apples. The noise of crunching leaves underfoot. I think that I'm going to get caught by a rolling pool. I see nothing because I've been here for hours. I imagine being rich again. I dream that I had a brilliant life before a rolling pool came along. He had like a black mask on. But the smell of cigarettes and the smell like smoke, you could smell smoke and you could smell a bit of like ale. I felt a bit scared.
Well, I was walking through the forest on my way home with my friends and then I heard a scream, so I was just like following the scream. And then, like, I just decided to go and investigate, so, and suddenly, like, something went over my head. I don't know what it was, and someone just dragged me into this weird place. I didn't know what to do. I was just panicking. It was, like, beating me up every day, and, like, it punched me in my face, and it really hurt me, and he fed me this really weird stuff that put me to sleep all the time. I think it's just because he wanted me to die or something like that. But he wanted the money from my parents. And like burning cigars, and then it's not like he was, like he had loads of alcohol. And he also smelled a bit sweaty. And like he never had a shower. So I don't know why that is. Because yeah, it was a massive room flowing through where we were. I'm quite angry as well, because we've still been fine how we are, and then they just like destroyed everything and stuff.
A man was kidnapping young rich ladies for a ransom wage off their parents. He smelt of smoke and old cigars. His clothes were scruffy and muddy of all the victims he'd captured. The only reason he kidnapped people was because his parents were kidnapped, then killed. So he was angry and got into business. He hid in a cave and chained women to a rock and waited for the ransom wage off their parents.
I kidnap young, rich ladies.
I have no family. I killed them all.
I bought a secret little lair, yes, if that's what you say nowadays.
I have a knife. I have a knife. I have a spoon for my earwax. Excuse me. Well, you don't have that sort of fashion nowadays, do you? Yes, I have a 5-year wash, so every 5 years I have a wash, yes.
What is your favourite food?
Hard one. Probably the intestines.
Of creatures?
Mostly humans. Humans. Yes.
Oh.
Written to you for ages, or should I say, long time no see. It's been a while since we've spoken. It is time to tell you how my life is going. I am not a thief anymore, so you shouldn't be a thief either. Anyway, are you still a thief? My life is amazing. Started like when I was stealing food in this house and the old lady caught me. We had a conversation of what was the point of doing it. It was true about everything she said. So I decided to get a job. It was hard at first, as I didn't earn much money, but I worked harder and harder. It took me to success. Now I have a wife and children. Also, I told them my experiences to them. I'm just really worried about you, that you will be caught and then be executed, so you won't see me. Also, I want you to feel safe. Then work hard and have a family so you won't be lonely anymore. That would be great. But you don't stop this. You'll be in big trouble. Soon you will feel guilty. I don't want that to happen. I'm warning you, must stop. I'm not forcing you, but it's the right decision. Yours sincerely, Adam. horrible aura of rotting leaves turning from green to brown in the soggy atmosphere. I was there imagining a warm aura from the sun repelling the bitterness of the cold weather. I wish I was there, but I wasn't in the blazing heat of the sun. I was in the damp woods where it was hailstorming, and I was feeling sorry for myself. The only thing that was warm was the spicy taste of curry from last night. Reassuring.
Footsteps fear my golden sword.
Cold stone walls. Danger running. Disgusting old age.
Death.
From the day I felt the guiltiest ever. I was bored, banging my head on sturdy walls, just being bored. So my parents gave me a mushroom, and I called it mushroomy. It was awesome, and I still have it to this day. It's just so dirty, and it's so small I can't encourage myself to wash it, because there is a possibility I'll lose it, and I can't cope without it. And back to the story now, anyway. Back to what happened. I was excited, I was hungry for adventure, and sick of being bored. My parents were getting ready for their next expedition. They were going to investigate the place to see what they're interested in they could find. Pet nothing to be honest, just a small bottle of water and leftover Pringles and mushroomy in my hand. We set off swiftly. But here comes the guilt. My rocks have been falling. Speaking to an adventurer fell. I tried my best in that, but it kept slipping on the loose gravel and rocks. I cried a lot that day, well, years. The hair on my face, it's cut. The only thing it does is grow back. Now look at me. I don't want this. The world is completely different.
Please welcome Jeff and Jeff's mum, Clett.
Woo!
Can you tell us a little bit more about your family?
I've got me mum, that's it. Me mum and me pizza.
How much on a scale of 1 to 10 would you say you like pizza?
0.
Or why do you carry pizza around with you?
I don't eat pizza, you know. So
much
playing with it.
So Colette, what is your biggest secret?
I don't really like to tell you in front of Jeff.
Okay. Jeff, do you think you could cover your ears for a minute?
Well, she loves that pizza too much, so I'll go up and hide it somewhere where she can never find it. Yes, I'm a naughty mother. I find it really irritating when Jeff talks to it. Pizza.
So what would he say if he knew that you did that?
That'll go mad at me.
Doesn't that make Jeff dangerous?
Yeah, but I say I sometimes do it. I don't often do it. Often. He often loses it, like, and then he blames me for it, losing it, and now Jeff here absolutely loves his pizza so much, You wouldn't intend to lose it, would you? You can uncover your ears now. Well, I haven't got a favourite food, but last time I intended to eat Jack's pizza, which I found for... God, see your face when I was about to eat it.
Yeah, do you have any friends other than your pizza, Jack?
No.
So, what do you talk to your pizza about?
Pizza.
Your mum's just told us that you sometimes lose your pizza. If you're so that is so much your friend and everything, how can you manage to lose it?
I'm about to drop it.
All right, can we have a round of applause for Jeff and Jack?
Left on my feet are no paws and no claws. I entered the cabin in 2010 on the last day of May. I have no money, I don't like the daylight. I go out and catch my food in the night. I live in Paul's cabin. I don't have pockets. I am a bat, I am skin and bones. I was born in 1919 and I am black and I can fly. I travelled from Africa. I travelled at night and slept in the trees. No one could see me, but they could hear me laughing. It took me 5 years to get here.
I feel the ground and my boots splintering with a very loud crack. Occasionally I find the odd skeleton among the large black pieces of obsidian, cooled lava and the occasional lava pit. Matt say over me to comfort me despite him being socially awkward. It always smells like someone is cooking, burning in a lava pit. Towers ripped from the skyline on the floor, shattered glass scattered over the ground. Nature has again claimed the land, vines and overgrown trees nearly as tall as the hovering towers. My tower, ripped apart, scattering across the nearby streets, sealing off the bottom of my alien penthouse tower. I step back with Matt, his neon blue lighting on his black leather jacket, offsetting his raven black hair with his ocean blue eyes and scarf. With a flash of lightning taking a large chunk off one of the towers downtown, we walk back through the blinding light of the portal, flying down weightless into the unknown.
Dear Campbell, your assistance over these past few years has been exceptional. The rock has finally been categorised and named after your good self. Young Geoffrey Campbell has finally given his name to the Geoffrelite crystal. But on more personal matters, how is your family? Is your father well? How about your charming bride, Claire? Hopefully your romance is more finely tuned than mine. One of our most disturbing moments is when my wife and I took our young girl out for a stroll. The gale was the strongest in years. Our hands swiftly became cold and rigid like ice, and our skin the colour of sour milk. Elisa even fainted like the sweet, fragile thing she is. It was a horror to see her so pale and weak. Although the sheer bliss of the warm drink brought her back to normality, my wife blames me for this incident and is threatening divorce. To defer the depressive nature of my own existence, let me congratulate you on gaining your diploma in chemical engineering. I know how you struggle with your dyslexia and how much of an achievement it has been for you. Thank you for the fossils you sent me as well. It is truly a privilege to hold 300-million-year-old Triphyllite in the palm of my hand. The rough texture of the shell really helps bring the alien form to life. Anyway, I hope this mutual hobby will keep us together. As for the Jephrolite, oh what a gem. This is the first I have spoken of it since I discovered it. The applications of clean energy are also painful to fully comprehend. Yet, what captivates me most of all is the crystal's exquisite beauty. It is precious to me. I'll send you the full report as soon as I can. In the meantime, I hope all is well, and please write back when you can. In the highest regards, your friend, Professor Charles Henry Ingham.
My full title is Charles Francis Ingham, noted geologist and adventurer. Very delighted to meet you, by the way.
How old are you?
I am 35 next month. I'm afraid my memory is somewhat failing me. Will you please be quiet?
Do you have a family?
There's my dear wife and child, but I don't intend to see them as much as I would love. That's what maybe one of the many curses of my profession last year. The year is 2503.
If you were born in my time, you'd see how much destruction you have, what luck has caused.
Raise your hand if you want to speak.
It's just plain good manners, dear.
I don't care what you want to say. Just take your time. You.
Quite a suit. Pretty.
Look like it's worn.
It's not
by a caveman.
It's not a suit. It's a jumper and some cheap jeans. I had to put time into my outfit. Look. Sure.
Next question, please.
Where do you sleep?
I sleep mainly in the field.
In a cave. He lives in a cave.
Technically, yes. I intend to sleep in a cave. Me and my team will spend a considerable amount of time underground.
What is the most important thing to you?
My most important discovery. This type of crystal I have categorized in the form of cytodiphora. It's about absorbing moisture from the caves for nutrients, and even responding to various flight or what we refer to as the flight or fight response, reacting to certain similar scenarios in the lab.
Yeah, are you famous?
Very much so.
No!
I don't like to be modest.
Most wanted man in the year 3021. Stupid, inferior geologist decided to pick up a rock which was telepathic and it became a sentient being which ended up destroying the world. He thought it would solve the world's biofuel or energy problems or something. It ended up creating more problems. I was a boy genius at 11. I invented a hoverboard at 11. At 18, I invented time travel and started taking people back.
Right.
I watched people die in front of me, die in my hands. I used to be a very sociable person. I used to be nice, friendly, fun. I used to laugh. Now I've just come in to pay for what he's done. Want to come back to the future with me and see what your little rock has done? Then you might believe me.
Well, it'll certainly be the discovery of a lifetime. That and my wife's chair have changed the locks again, so why not?
water ball in fresh air and Doritos makes my tummy rumble. It's raining cats and dogs. Leaf crunch, birds whistle, and close by twigs snap. Breakfast, Doritos and jawbreakers are sweet and sour in my mouth. I can get to the top of the hill. I am happy halfway there. Bees swarm and crickets chirp. People chat. A man will come, he will chop all the trees down. I dream that money comes forth from the sky.